Hey guys, Paul from UltimateFatBurner.com here, and today I'm going to talk about BCAA side effects. I'll be right back in just a moment. Stick around. Don't go anywhere. All right, welcome back. Now, a couple of quick points before I begin. The first, I provided the links to the clinical studies that support the statements I make in this video in the description field below this video. You'll also find a link to the full BCAA article on UltimateFatBurner.com. The second thing is, while you're here, why not subscribe while you're thinking about it? It's a lot more fun making these videos when someone ends up watching them, and it'd be really cool to have you as part of this growing community. One click, all it takes. All right. Last thing, it's important to keep these points about BCAA side effects in their proper context. Now, I know the internet is a place where the more outrageous the claims, the more people are going to tune in. I bet there'd be more interest in this video if I titled it something like 5 Horrifying Side Effects of Branched Chain Amino Acids or something like that. But that would be total bullshit, and if you've watched any of my videos, you'll know that I'm really not that big on bullshit. After all, BCAAs occur naturally in everyday foods like beef, chicken, eggs, and dairy products, as well as some vegetarian sources of protein. So, even if you're not actively taking a BCAA supplement, you're still consuming them regularly. So while BCAAs do have some side effects, they are relatively rare, and for most people, these supplements are very safe. Heck, BCAAs are a FDA-approved injectable product. All right, with that said, let's get started on the side effects. Side effect number one. When taken orally or intravenously, branched chain amino acids can lead to an increase in plasma ammonia levels, but at a 60 gram a day dose, not to toxic plasma levels. So what does an increase in ammonia mean? Well, from a practical perspective, it can lead to fatigue and a loss of motor coordination. Side effect number two, in some cases, BCAA consumption can cause nausea. Side effect number three, some evidence suggests BCAAs may stimulate an insulin response, which may result in a hypoglycemic effect or a sudden drop in blood sugar levels. For sensitive individuals and people with diabetes, this may be a matter of some concern. Side effect number four, with individuals with certain conditions or diseases, BCAA supplementation can be associated with seizures, liver disease, lung failure, and brain damage. Some examples of such diseases include branched chain ketoaciduria, chronic alcoholism, and Lou Gehrig's disease. Side effect number five, BCAAs can interfere with some drugs which may cause an increase or decrease in their effectiveness. Two examples of drugs that may be affected are diabetes drugs and levodopa, which is used to treat Parkinson's disease. All right, guys, there you have it, 5 BCAA side effects. If you found this video helpful, a thumbs up or a share would be awesome. I'd really appreciate it. If you've taken branched chain amino acids and want to share your experiences, that would also be very cool. Please leave a comment below. If you have a question, by all means, you can leave one there as well. One last thing before I go, why not subscribe to this channel if you haven't already? It'd be awesome to have you as part of this growing community, and I would really appreciate it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.